Justin Price, and I'm the creator of the BioMechanics Method, which provides corrective exercise education for health and fitness professionals. Today I want to talk to you about some things you may not have thought about in relation to corrective exercise when helping you and your clients overcome their muscle and joint pain. Now, a lot of times a client will come into you with a problem like a knee pain or a back pain or a shoulder pain, but most of the time the symptom is not usually the cause. For example, someone may have come into you with pain on the outside of their knee, and it may have been caused by the fact that they're right-handed. For example, if someone's right-handed and they're always reaching forward to either the mouse or playing tennis, that brings the arm forward and across the body. The shoulder blade follows, the rib cage follows. As the rib cage rotates to the left, that rotates my pelvis down and forward. My leg rotates in, which would then overpronate the right foot. Now, if I'm walking and I overpronate this right foot because of my right arm swing, I'm actually going to fall to the left. So every time I'm walking, I'm going to actually put weight to the outside of my left knee. So if you look at it and you understand where to look at clients' body to understand where they're most out of alignment, you can then find the cause of their symptom, address the cause, and their symptom will go away and they'll be very happy. Another thing you may not have thought about is unconscious habits can be very detrimental to the body. For example, I had a client coming in with severe IT band pain, so they had IT band syndrome, which is pain down the outside of their leg, and I went through a lot of assessments with them, and what we found out was actually the reason why they were getting continuous IT band syndrome was the fact that they were running and they were talking to a partner on their left. So let me explain that to you. When you're running and you're moving along and the leg is rotating in over the foot as you collapse and transfer weight, that's going to pull the leg slightly in, and then you're going to transfer weight, and it's going to happen on the same on the left-hand side. However, if someone's running and their best friend is over here and they're running, they're talking the whole time, that turning of the head then turns the neck, then pulls the shoulder, pulls the rib cage, and similarly, like we saw in the first example, turns the leg in, and now they get a big tug on the right IT band. So I had the client get their best friend to run on the other side for a month. The pain went away. Now they alternate side to side when they're running, so her IT band's pain doesn't come back. And oddly enough, her friend, who was running on this side, lots of her aches and pains went away when they switched up sides as well. Another thing you may not have thought about is stress. So emotional, psychological stress can also manifest itself as physical pain. For example, you may not have thought that if you've got gastrointestinal stress or IBS, which is irritable bowel syndrome, that can actually lead to musculoskeletal pain. The ascending colon is actually attached by connective tissue to a various number of muscles, but two of the biggest ones are your quadratus lumborum, which is a muscle in your back which actually hikes the hip and slows down the rib cage as it moves away from the hip. So it's a big muscle here that does this or slows down this. It also, the ascending colon, shares connective tissue with the iliacus, which is a hip flexor muscle, which slows down hip extension and pelvis rotation and leg and hip flexion. So if you have gastrointestinal stress as a result of stressing out too much, so you get stressed and then your gut blows up, those of you that know about IBS and so forth will know that when you get stressed, you start getting, your stomach starts growling, then you start getting gastrointestinal stress, and then next day you wake up and go, I don't know why my back hurts. Think about the emotional triggers that cause the stress to the gut, which then show up as back pain or sacroiliac joint pain and so forth. So consider these things that you may never have thought about. Make sure you ask appropriate questions of your clients so that you can look for not just the physical problems that you associate with muscle, joint, and pain, but the other issues that may help improve the success when working with your clients in corrective exercise. Hope you've learned something, and I'll see you next time.